This video is about the office of Prime Minister and his Council of Ministers. The President of India is the constitutional executive head. The real head of the government is the Prime Minister and his Council of Ministers. All decisions are taken in the name of the President, but the President cannot act on his own. According to the Constitution, the President can only act on aid and advice of the Prime Minister and Council of Ministers. The President appoints the Prime Minister, and on advice of the Prime Minister, the President appoints the Council of Ministers. As per convention, the leader of the majority party in the legislature is invited by the President to form the government. In case there is no single largest party, the leader of coalition is appointed as the Prime Minister. Basically, the President should appoint a person who is in position to win the confidence of the majority in that house. The Prime Minister enjoys a central position to the Council of Ministers. The Prime Minister and the Council of Ministers enjoy office during the pleasure of the President. Let's talk about the Council of Ministers. Council of Ministers has ministers of different ranks. These ranks are not specified in the Constitution, but rather done informally following the English practice. There are three ranks of Council of Ministers: Cabinet Ministers, Ministers of State, and Deputy Ministers. Cabinet Ministers is an informal body of senior ministers who form the inner circle of the Council of Ministers. A cabinet minister leads a ministry. Ministers of State are an outer circle. Ministers of State are of two kinds. Ministers of State with an independent charge have charge of a ministry. A minister of state with an independent charge is a junior minister who does not report to a cabinet minister. A minister of state without an independent charge is a junior minister who reports to a cabinet minister. A minister of state is usually given a specific responsibility in that ministry. Then we have the deputy ministers. Deputy ministers are those ministers who have not been given an independent charge of the ministry. Deputy ministers assist ministers of state or cabinet ministers. They don't take part in any cabinet deliberations. Council of Ministers hardly meets as a body. It is the cabinet which meets as and when summoned by the Prime Minister. Cabinet ministers attend cabinet meetings of their own right. Ministers of State only attend meetings on invitation. In order to limit the size of a ministry, the Constitution of India has been amended in 2004. According to the 91st Amendment to the Constitution in 2004, the total number of ministers of the Council of Ministers, including a Prime Minister, should not exceed 15% of the total members of the Lok Sabha. The same law applies to the state legislatures also. A minister must be a member of either house of the parliament. A person who is not a member of either house of the parliament can be appointed as a minister, but he cannot continue as a minister for more than 6 months unless he becomes a member of either house of the parliament, that may be by election or nomination. Council of Ministers, or the ministry as a body, is collectively responsible to the legislature. The ministers are also individually responsible to the executive head, that is the President. We'll learn about the collective and individual responsibility in the next video.